have close to about 5,000 artifacts, and about 5 or 6 of them are exceedingly rare. They are one-of-a-kind items that you will not see any other place on the face of the earth. They are a testament to how critical and important this discipline has been, not only to the United States, but really to humanity.
We get a lot of our artifacts from NSA directly. We focus on certain eras like Revolutionary War, Civil War, World War I, World War II, and present. And so we'll take rare items that may not necessarily be exactly related to cryptology. However, it's a very rare item, and so it's great for us to have in our collection. We do often think about if it would look good in an exhibit and if the public would be interested in it. Something that just recently came into our collection, which is kind of cool, is a white mailbox, and that sat on the chief of counterterrorism's desk in the mid-2000s. And the mailbox held recommendation packages to initiate collection under the terrorist surveillance program. It held very, very powerful documents.
In this room, there are a little bit over 11,000 books. We have about 400 rare books. What I think is the largest collection of commercial code books. So these code books were used by companies from the dawn of the telegraph age up through kind of the maturity of machine encryption in the 20s and 30s. If you can combine that story with an artifact, you know, a physical thing or a book, the overlap between those makes the story resonate that much more.
We are, in many respects, ground zero for cryptologic research and information. I think that's one of the really special things about this facility is it's able to impart to people just how important the making and breaking of codes has been and will continue to be in the future.